There's a lot of people asking about it, obviously.
I want to find these boys.
Things are looking bleak.
There's too many missing cases in this town.
It's one thing when you see these stories on TV and they're mm-hmm. happening somewhere else, and you know, you repost the pictures, you repost the memes and everything.
So then I came home and I told my wife, we need to call the cops.
My babies are supposed to be missing from this house.
But when it happens right down the street, oh, it hits a little bit different.
Some kids that come up missing, it's terrifying.
This is a great opportunity for somebody to come forward and with the right information and help us get to the truth.
A year ago today, December 21st, brothers Orson and Orrin West were reported missing. 12 months of prayer vigils and searches. 1 year of asking questions that as of today have no answers. 17 News has followed this case since day one, and now we have new information. Information that could unlock clues that might help answer one question: where are the boys?
December 2020, the COVID pandemic is on hold as the small desert community rallies around the Christmas holiday. Something is not right on Aspen Avenue. On that chilly Monday afternoon, Christmas joy turned dire in the neighborhood where Trezell and Jacqueline West lived with their children. The tragic story of Orrin and Orson West began to unfold. They were just 3 and 4 years old.
But that story starts back here in Bakersfield, a couple of years earlier, where the boys were born to their biological mother, Ryan Dean. She gave the boys their birth names, Sincere and Classic, with the last name of Pettis from their father, Charles Pettis.
I was at work. I noticed my baby cry wasn't normal when I got home, and I took him straight to the hospital.
The baby she's talking about is Orrin West, the older boy.
And they say he had a femur bone. His femur bone was broken and twisted.
She says this injury led to Child Protective Services taking both boys from her.
I come from a good background. Like, I don't have a police record, never been in jail.
The last time Dean saw her boys was the end of 2018. Taken from her, the boys were placed in the system. 34-year-old Trezell West and 31-year-old Jacqueline West became the boys' parents, responsible for their well-being, providing them a home. Eventually, the parents became the adoptive parents in 2019, renaming them Orrin and Orson West. The West home became fuller. There were already 4 other kids in the family, 2 biological and 2 adopted. The following year, the family moved to California City. All seemed well until Christmas 2020.
And they came to us and they became our children. We named them. And they are our children. And so we want them back.
Trezell wanted to build a fire in the fireplace, and he went out the back door with the boys. He opened the side gate and left the yard to gather firewood, walking past the boys as he carried the logs into the house.
He said, well, I didn't see him, so I came back outside and I started searching my backyard. I searched the whole thing. I realized that I left the gate open and I panicked, came inside the house, searched the house, me and my wife.
A neighbor's security camera shows the family's white van. The camera stated 4:32, but police confirmed the clock was off. It was really 5:32 in the evening.
I turned my light on, I searched, I called their names. Talked to a gentleman on the street on the other side over there, he didn't see me.
He called the California City Police just before 6, and the boys remained missing overnight. The next day, after searching the town and the nearby desert, California City Police got a warrant for the West house. It became the first of many examinations of that property on Aspen Avenue. Canines went inside to track the boys' scent. The local police chief says the dogs found the scent inside the home, but didn't detect the children leaving the house.
Let your imagination run wild. What I do truly believe is that night, there's no way that they could have got out of that the neighborhood without some sort of assistance.
The investigation ramps up. Police dug up the backyard. A few months go by and nothing new. No updates from police. The search slows. On March 1st, the FBI and Bakersfield Police took the lead on the investigation.
5 days later, more than 50 officers and FBI agents searched for evidence in a southeast Bakersfield dirt lot. It's located near the Casa Loma apartments where Trezell and Jacqueline West used to live. Police say the adopted parents have been cooperative. Chief Walker confirmed the other four kids living in the home were taken into foster care and will remain there until a court case is settled.
Trezell and Jacqueline West moved back to Bakersfield. The California City home is now boarded up and vacant. We've reached out to them multiple times for this story, by phone, email, and social media, and never received a response.
I don't know. I think trafficking.
Many people believe they have the answer.
I believe they were trafficked.
You know, it'd be sheer speculation, but I feel that, you know, in my heart, in my investigative skill set, it's over 20 years in the largest police department in the United States. I felt that immediately the story that was being portrayed by the adoptive parents was not true. It didn't make sense. It didn't add up.
There's a number of possibilities that could have happened. I mean, and I don't even want to speculate because, again, it's still an ongoing investigation. So I don't want to, you know, give away any of my opinions because those are just that, opinions. I know how the investigation's gone and the way it's pointing, but again, because it's ongoing, I can't really comment too much on that.
We use facts that are only known to law enforcement to impeach statements. And so I'm not going to be the one that's going to provide information. This case is too important. This investigation is too important. And I'm not going to be the one to mess it up.
My faith was that it wasn't going to go this long. You know, so I had to realize that it's not my timing. It's God's timing on everything.
Biological father Charles Pettis shares his thoughts.
But it's not nothing like you should just be like, oh, well, I don't know. If you did something, let people know. Because you hurting people's kids, you taking family away from family, you know what I mean? These were babies, you feel me?
The frustration is evident, but there is that new information. 17 News has learned of some human remains found out here in the desert landscape surrounding California City. Could this be the smoking gun that breaks the case wide open?
Well, they were missing for nearly a year until, obviously, unfortunately, remains were discovered not too far from the home where they were.
Antonio Castillo and Darren Ritchie are lawyers now representing the Pettis family as they seek to hold Kern County CPS accountable for placing the children in what they say was a dangerous situation.
17 News obtained a copy of a September 2021 complaint filed by Pettis and his mother, Brenda Pettis. They allege the placement of Classic and Sincere under the care of the West was negligent, therefore leading to a presumed wrongful death of both brothers. Kern County CPS has yet to respond to our request for comment.
They recently found human remains. It looks like that was in the beginning of November. The children's father, you know, Mr. Pettis, went in to allow, you know, blood to be drawn so that they could see if there was a potential DNA match with the remains of Sincere and Classic.
And we believe that they are responsible for the disappearance, and we'll see if that turns into more. And it's incumbent upon these bureaucratic government agencies to do more with respect to the lives of children. We're not just taking a puppy from one shelter to another. These are human beings.
9 months after assuming the case, Bakersfield Police Department continues the investigation, but still no answers, no suspects, and no boys.
It may cause people to, if there are people involved in criminal activity, to understand that they're under scrutiny. And there's certain things that we just can't present to the public to satisfy a curiosity.
They have 90% of their leads that they're not making available to the public, and they're doing it for a very good reason, because they need to keep the investigation, the integrity of this investigation. They cannot jeopardize it because we're talking about two little boys.
The adoptive parents remain silent since their last statement released to the public in March 2021.
All sides should be out here together looking for the babies. That's all I said. But you know, you can't force anybody to do something they're not wanting to do.
Based on what we were given, we have to operate on the assumption that they were here.
Allegedly, they was taken on the 21st, but I don't believe nothing happened in California City.
I 100% wholeheartedly concur that they were not ever in California City. I can tell you this, Christian, is that we now know the areas where the boys are not.
There are answers out there. Someone must know something. If you have any of those answers or feel you could help, please call Kern Secret Witness. You can remain anonymous. call 661-322-4040. In California City, contact the California City Police tip line at 855-227-3656. With your help, we can all answer the question, where are the boys? The mystery of two boys missing from their California City home. Toddlers vanished from a backyard, leaving more questions than answers. In an exclusive interview, Charles Pettis, the brother's biological father, tells us about the pain that only a parent could possibly understand.
I think the day that they have put the report on the news that the kids were missing, and then somebody told me to look on Facebook, and I don't have social media, but I was going through family members' phones and they were showing it, and we watched the news, and that's how we found out. We didn't even know that they sent them out to some different people.
Headline after headline, Pettis was left in disbelief, shocked by descriptions of how the adoptive parents had left his boys unattended.
It's real obvious that y'all already knew that these kids was outside, and basically saying that these kids were outside unattended and y'all go back in the house to the other kids and come back outside and these kids are gone. Y'all know what happened, y'all know what was going on, y'all know what was up with all of that was happening. Everything was, it was janky. It wasn't nothing right.
From that day forward, a part of Pettis has been missing.
They took my family. They took my life away from me. My kids is my life. That's my family.
Pettis clings to hope his children will return.
It's not making no sense, but you know, I'm just waiting for it to all come together and my kids come home. That's about it. Don't nobody know what's going on with them. They can be, anything could be happening to them, and they could be perfectly fine too. But you know, it's not right.
The father has felt the pain of losing a child in an out-of-state car accident a decade ago. The child was under the care of Pettis' partner at the time, emotions that he would never want to have to relive again, especially if this case ends in the worst way possible.
I will never put a doubt that my kids are dead, because I would hate to go through that all over again. It's hard to close that hole once it's open. So I don't want my kids to be deceased. I want them to come back home, because if my kids is all I got. After my parents go, it's just me and my kids.
Silence from the adoptive parents, Trezell and Jacqueline West, simply adds salt to the wound.
They have no words, so I have no words either. They know what happened. Don't try to hide it, you know? Whatever you do in the dark, come to light anyway. So if they did do something, they'd be in trouble for it. I won't sit up here and just, you know, try to rattle my brain. Hopefully, you know, they'll come in, hopefully pop up, you know, by the grace of God, maybe, you know what I mean? That these people just need to just let it go and just let them kids go, let my kids come back home, because, you know, that don't make no sense.
There are answers out there. Someone must know something. If you have any of those answers or feel you could help, please call Kern Secret Witness. You can remain anonymous. Call 661-322-4040. In California City, contact the California City Police tip line at 855-227-3656. With your help, we can all answer the question, where are the boys?
We are a small town. So for one of our own to be missing, we took it personal.
We don't even know each other, but we're all here for the same reasons.
I thank everyone so much.
California City has many secrets. Cold case files piling up about the missing and murdered. Many questions that deserve answers.
Her husband had put a shotgun to her face in front of my granddaughter and basically threatened her life.
That day, almost 10 years ago, was the last time Sherry Smith saw her daughter, Desiree Thompson. It was the same day Desiree was in a domestic dispute with her estranged husband. She was planning on leaving him. That morning started out as just another day.
She was in good spirits. We discussed the fact of her moving on, and she was waiting on grant money to come in from college courses that she had applied for. And she was gonna go find another place and move away from him.
Desiree called her mom at about 8:30 that night. Smith now realizes it was the last time she heard her daughter's voice. She filed a missing persons report. An investigation began, interviews, searches, posters. And then, nothing.
Nothing. My daughter would have never. My daughter would have never left her kids. She would never left me. She loved her kids.
The California City Police named the estranged husband, Edward Gibson III, as a person of interest. When I checked in October, they didn't know where he was, if he was even still in California. The investigator in charge of the case told me then a lack of resources and turnover in personnel over the years has delayed the investigation. As Orrin and Orson's anniversary passes, the 10th anniversary approaches for a heartbroken mother who sees an investigation that has discovered nothing. Debbie Phones knows that pain. She's the mother of 23-year-old Devery Schiller. On June 26, 2016, Devery's body was found in the park across the street from the home she shared with her mother. Investigators believe Devery was strangled to death.
And then my daughter died and I started digging, like looking, and it's like, oh my God, wait a minute.
5 years later, as in the Desiree Thompson case, nothing. In the Schiller case, the mom did most of the investigating. In 2019, she saw the movie Three Billboards Outside Ebbing, Missouri. Inspired by the film, she rented three billboards outside California City, begging for help solving her daughter's killing. Still, nothing. Just this summer, the NBC program Dateline featured eight California City Police Department cold case homicides.
Pete Hammond has been missing since July of 2017. Devery Schiller, in 2016, June 26, was murdered, strangled in the park. Robert Austin Tharp went missing in 2014. Dimitri Thomas was visiting here in California City. Dimitri was the victim of a drive-by shooting. Charles Piper was actually a planning commissioner for the California City. Very friendly. Desiree Thompson is an unusual case. In 2012, her ex-husband, Edward Gibson, originally from Hawthorne, had taken Devery out of her home in front of her four children at gunpoint. Both she and the ex-husband have been missing ever since. Matthew Leninger was killed as he slept in a home in California City, January of 2010. Burdette Thorbist, oldest case that we're currently working in California City. It's a 2001 murder.
It's a lot for a town of 14,000. Those crimes have been documented. There's no telling what unreported mysteries lie in the sagebrush of the huge desert that borders Cal City on all sides.
It's a dark element out there. And there should not be so many cold cases not being solved, not being cared about.
Inaction from local police is a common complaint.
Currently, we have a very small department. I don't know if you know, but we're in landmass, we're the third largest city in the state of California after Los Angeles and San Diego. We've got 205 square miles, and including myself, sworn personnel, we have 14 people.
Is that the reason why so many other cases have sort of, quote unquote, gone cold?
No, I don't think so. In fact, the cold cases we do have, we still are actively working. I have one criminal investigator that I have part-time, that he's here 4 days a week working those cases and actively following up on any leads.
I believe the line goes something, it is being worked on and it's progressing.
We're still actively working it. I mean, I can't give you a whole lot more than that, but we still are actively working that.
What does that mean to you? What does California City mean to you?
I despise it. I despise everything about Cal City.
These are just a few of the cases that have gone unsolved in California City. Cases that could be closed with one phone call. If you have any information that could bring justice to these families, call the California City Police tip line, 855-227-3656.
Every day for the past year, thousands of drivers traveling along Highway 99 see the faces of Orson and Orrin West, two brothers missing from their backyard in California City. Billboards crying out, asking, where are the boys?
Yeah, I saw something like on a Facebook clip with KGT, because I have you guys like on my Facebook. They're trying to get money generated through this GoFundMe to get billboards going to find these two missing children.
An interview that countless others watched, but one that inspired Jennifer Nobles to invest her time and money to help find the boys.
But it did inspire one person, and that person was pretty big.
We sponsored the digital billboard. And the reason I thought it was very important to sponsor that digital billboard is because having the kids' face and names out in social media, out to the general public. That is crucial to have this case not go cold in the public eye.
Let's just say it's my own children and they went missing. I would just hope and pray that the community would come together the way that they did with these two guys.
There are answers out there. Someone must know something. If you have any of those answers or feel you could help, please call Kern Secret Witness. You can remain anonymous. Call 661-322-4040. In California City, contact the California City Police tip line at 855-227-3656. With your help, we can all answer the question, where are the boys? I'm Christian Galeno for 17 News.